We've had a question from Jerry Marcus, who's asked us about painting the Minotaur's chapter of Space Marines and how to do their power armour. So we're looking at brass power armour for this, and I'm going to show you a great way of how you can go about doing it. Now, first of all, we're going to base coat the armour using Balthazar Gold, and then we're going to dry brush over that with Runelord Brass to start to bring out the detail. Then we'll shade all over it with Agrax Earthshade Gloss to keep the shine there, then dry brush once again with Runelord Brass before we finish off, optionally, with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. But starting out with Balthazar Gold for our base colour, I'm going to go straight to my large base brush for this one, and all you want to do is paint all of your armor with this color. And on your marine, I recommend you do this before any other detail, because well, for this first stage, it means that you can be a little bit messy as you apply the color. So thin the paint down so it's nice and smooth, and then when you're ready, just start applying it to your space marine. I'm going to focus towards the top of the miniature here to show you what to do, but I recommend you paint the entire thing, and also be sure to apply two thin coats of this color as well. Once you've built up the base colour, the next thing to do is start highlighting by dry brushing the armour using Runelord Brass. And I'm using a small dry brush here, and I just want to gradually build up that colour to keep the armour nice and smooth. With that done, we're now ready to apply an all-over shade of Agrax Earthshade Gloss to the armour. Now, we're using gloss for this because it's going to give us a nice definition in all the recesses of the detail, but at the same time, it'll keep that nice metallic shine once it's dry. Once the Agrax Earthshade Gloss is completely dry, we're ready to finish off the highlights. So first we're going back to Runelord Brass, another dry brush this time, but just do it a little bit lighter than he did previously. And there we are, the armour's looking great, but if you want to take it just a little bit further, you can add an edge highlight of Stormhost Silver, but whether you do or not, of course, is entirely up to you. For this, you're looking to follow all the very sharpest edges of the armour panels. And once you've finished applying that highlight, the bronze armour's complete, and well, you're ready to start painting in all the other details. But, well, there you go, that's all there is to it, really. Jerry, I hope that's been really useful to you, and it helps you get started painting your Minotaurs. And we'll see you all again very soon.